Pressure is mounting on lawmakers and White House officials who met again today as they scramble to secure a deal on the president's Build Back Better agenda. But key sticking points remain, like how to pay for the massive social spending measure. For the latest on negotiations, I'm joined by our White House correspondent, Yamiche Alcindor. So hello, Yamiche. They are under the gun right now. Tell us what White House and officials and the president are doing to try to reach a deal, and tell us what the latest sticking points are.
Well, President Biden and White House officials are scrambling, Judy, scrambling to try to make a deal, to try to unite the Democratic Party so that the president, when he leaves for Europe tomorrow, can have something to talk about to our European allies. That being said, there are a lot of meetings going on, and the White House has been saying that they're confident that a deal could possibly be reached tonight or by tomorrow. But it's really hard to see that coming together because the details of the bill are still really being worked out. White House officials that I have been talking to in the last hour say that really developments have been changing hour by hour. Now, today, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki, she said she was confident that a possibility of a deal could still be reached. I pressed her on why she felt confident, given the fact that the details are still being worked out. Here's what she told me.
I think what members of Congress have conveyed to all of you and leaders in Congress, as well as the White House and the president, is that we are very close. That's because we are very close. And it does require working through specific details and components that need to be finalized before we have a final agreement.
Now, the key part of what she said, there are specific details and components. So in the last hour, we learned between myself as well as Lisa Desjardins, our Capitol Hill correspondent, that one big key provision that Democrats wanted in, that progressive Democrats wanted in, is already being seen as likely out of the deal, and that is paid family leave. Now, the president, as well as progressives, had been initially pushing for 12 weeks of family paid leave, which is in some ways mirroring what happens in other countries. That was then whittled down to 4 weeks. And now, within the last hour, White House officials as well as Capitol Hill sources are telling us that that is likely out. And it's out because Senator Joe Manchin does not want it in. And what this is really shaping up to be is really a bill that is mirroring what Joe Manchin wants rather than what progressive Democrats wants. Another thing to really look out for in terms of what's being worked out is how to pay for all of this. Now, there was this billionaire tax that had been floated by Senate Democrats. And today, President Biden, through his White House press secretary, came out and said he was in support of the billionaire tax. But again, Senator Manchin came out and said that he was critical of this tax. He said that he did not want to be targeting people. So again, it seems as though the billionaire tax is dead on arrival. The ink isn't even dry on that sort of provision, but it's already gone. And it's again because of Senator Manchin of West Virginia.
And Yamiche, we've been reporting that President Biden was very much hoping to get this done before he leaves tomorrow for the global climate summit in Europe. How concerned is he that he may leave without a deal? And what do the chances look like that there could be something before tomorrow?
Well, White House officials have been very candid about the idea that President Biden absolutely wants a deal before he gets on a plane to go to Europe. And he's going to be meeting with the Pope. He's going to be meeting with a number of European allies at the G20. He's also going to be going to a climate change conference. At all of those meetings, he wants to be able to say, here's what Democrats can get done. Here's what Democrats are doing on climate change, on paid family leave, on all of these different provisions, even though, as I said, paid family leave is likely out. But it's really, really unclear whether or not he's going to get his wish. He really wants a victory here. The White House is still insisting that there's been a lot of progress, that something could happen. Another thing to note is that House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, she wrote a letter to lawmakers today saying that tomorrow the House Rules Committee is going to hold a hearing on what she's calling the Build Back Better Act. So that is Nancy Pelosi really in some ways trying to telegraph the urgency that lawmakers want to move here with. And there's reporting that she's telling committee chairs that she wants to see a text of the bill by tomorrow's rules hearing. Again, it's very up in the air whether or not that's going to happen. Progressives are saying that they want to see a text of the legislation, the reconciliation legislation, before they vote on the bipartisan bill. So really, when the president walks out tomorrow at the White House, it's anyone's guess whether or not he's going to be able to say, yes, we have a deal, or no, we don't. Tonight, there was talk that he might go to Capitol Hill, but the White House called what we call a lid. And that means that we're not going to see the president on camera, and we're not going to see the president go to Capitol Hill tonight.
So many moving parts, and the drama continues. Yamiche Alcindor watching it at the White House. Thank you, Yamiche.